was 19, you were 21. The year we got engaged. And everyone said we were much too young, but we did it anyway. We got the rings for 40 each from a pawn shop down the road. And we said our vows and took the leap now 15 years ago. Dancing in the minefields, we went sailing in the storms, and it was harder than we dreamed, but I believe that's what the promise is for. Well, I do are the two most famous last words, the beginning of the end. But to lose your life for another, I've heard, to begin. 'Cause the only way to find your life is to lay your own life down. And I believe it's an easy price for the life that we have found. And we're dancing in the minefields, we're sailing in the storms, and this is harder than we dreamed, but I believe that's what the promise is for. Is for. So when I lose my way, find me, and when I lose love's chains, bind me at the end of all my faith, to the end of all my days, when I forget my name, remind me. 'Cause we bear the light of the Son of Man, so there's nothing left to fear. So I'll walk with you in the shadowlands till the shadows disappear. 'Cause he promised not to leave us, and his promises are true. So in the face of all this chaos, baby, I can dance with you. So let's go dancing in the minefields. Let's go sailing in the storms. Oh, let's go dancing in the minefields and kicking down the doors. Oh, let's go dancing in the minefields and sailing in the storms. Oh, this is harder than we dreamed, that I believe that's what the promise is for.
Front of you to see. but make sure that's what you want while you're still free. The only goal I have for you is in this wedding band, 'cause all I have to offer you is me. There'll be no mansions waiting on the hill with crystal chandeliers, and there'll be no fancy clothes for you to wear. Everything I have is standing here in front of you to see.
Just you know why you and I will by and by know true love waits. Sometimes we'll say, just you and I know true love waits. Just you and I know true love waits. No true love waits.
When I first saw you, I saw love. And the first time you touched me, I felt love. And after all this time, you're still the one I love.
Looks like we made it. Look how far we've come, my baby. We might have took the long way. We knew we'd get there someday. They said, I bet they'll never make it. But just look at us holding on. We're still together, still going strong. Still, you're still the one I run to, the one that I belong to. You're still the one I want for life. You're still the one that I love, the only one I dream of. You're still the one I kiss goodnight. Ain't nothing better. We'd be the odds together. I'm glad we didn't listen. Look at what we would be missing. They said, they'll never make it, but just look at us holding on. We're still together, still going strong.
Still,
you're still the one I run to, the one that I belong to. You're still the one I want.
This song at your wedding?
Yeah.
It's beautiful.
Okay. And that's why we
have
it.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to give another 50
years. Amen.
She wrote it burning on there.
It's okay. Everybody knows who you are. You have them turn it down. Turn it down. You can turn it down. I'm just telling them to go ahead and lower it down. Bennie and Millie would like to thank you for coming to the celebration. And by the way, that song was at their wedding 50 years ago. Some of us are old enough to remember that song, aren't we? Okay. Well, this is a call to celebration. And dear friends, we are gathered here today in the presence of God to celebrate Bennie and Millie Warren's 50th wedding anniversary. And they would like to publicly renew their vows to the Lord and to one another. In the Old Testament of Scripture, we read how God's people celebrated 50 years, which was called the Year of Jubilee. And it was a year of renewal every 50 years. It involved of forgiveness, Aren't you thankful for forgiveness and redemption? And it's a beautiful picture of what Christ has done for us, redeemed us and forgave us. And so one of the things that they did for this celebration, it was a big feast and it was a great celebration. They would rejoice. The word jubilee actually means horn, ram's horn, and they would blow a shofar to begin the celebration. So Pastor Brent's going to come at this time and to blow the shofar. So let's celebrate together. Amen. Wow. Would you bow with me for prayer? Father in heaven, I thank you so much for your son, Jesus. Thank you for grace and mercy. We all need it. And I pray your blessing on this ceremony for Bennie and Millie. Thank you for their marriage of 50 years. And thank you for their friends and family that are here. And I pray your blessing on each one. In Christ's name, amen. At this time, Bennie and Millie would like to show a video. It's called God Gave Me You. Was this at your wedding?
No.
No, this is okay. All right. We're going to watch a video up front here.
Of me,
Amen. Well, Bennie and Millie were married 50 years ago yesterday. Is that right? Mm-hmm. Okay, December 30th, 1972. And that's awesome. So Pastor Dan and I met with Bennie and Millie, and we talked about several things. And back then, you have to realize they had some people that wasn't sure you were going to make this this marriage was going to work. But so I'm going to have a call. Bennie and Millie wanted me to do this. If there's any objection to this marriage, speak now or forever hold your peace. And if you do speak up, you're in trouble. Where were you 50 years ago? So you were there. Okay, we're in trouble, Bennie. Oh, you know, we did discuss, they both weren't really believers back then. It was about 10 years after they'd been married that they became believers. And you know what? That makes a difference. That's what makes a difference in a marriage, in our individual lives, but our lives as we commit our lives to the Lord. In Scripture, we see how Joshua gathered people together, the people of God, and they publicly renewed and made a new commitment to the Lord. And that's, I believe it's important to do that. And Joshua, let me read this for you in Joshua 24. It says, then Joshua assembled all the people, and they presented themselves to the Lord. And that's what you two are doing today in front of all these people. Okay? And so we've gathered here together in the presence of God, and you're going to recommit and renew your vows in just a little bit to one another and to the Lord most of all. See, Joshua started to share with the people, and I want to share this with you. We need to remember the covenant that we've made with the Lord. We need to remember the covenant and the promise that God has for us as his people. Joshua reminded the people that there was years in their life they didn't serve the Lord. In fact, they were serving other gods, other things in this world, and not the Lord. Fame and money and pleasures, and they were in bondage. In fact, he reminded them of how God delivered them, their people, out of 400 years of slavery and bondage, and then how they wandered in the wilderness for 40 years because of their disbelief. And so we need to understand that it's only because of the Lord that we can make it in this life. And so Joshua goes on, he says this promise. He says that you need to remember God's promise. You will enter into the promised land. And so we were talking together, and you guys said that you pray the Lord gives you another 50 years. no matter what, God promises us the best is yet to come. Because we have the hope of eternity through Christ our Lord. And that's what's so important. So Joshua publicly committed himself to the Lord. He said, choose for yourself this day who you will serve. But as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. And I know that's your guys' heart here too. And it says in Scripture, three times they recommitted themselves to the Lord at that in that one setting. Let me read this for you. The people answered Joshua, we too will serve the Lord because he is our God. And a little bit later in verse 21, he says, we will serve the Lord. They said that to him. And then Joshua said to all the people, you're witnesses to one another. You that are here today are witnesses to their life and their commitment to the Lord. And then the people said in verse 24, we will serve the Lord and obey him. That's important. We say, well, we serve the Lord, but we have to obey him, obey his word. See, he has things for us to obey, but for our own good. A lot of people don't quite understand that. I've always, when I've obeyed the Lord, I've never regretted it. But when I did not obey the Lord, I've always regretted it. Because he has good things for his people. So on that day, Joshua made a covenant for the people of God with the Lord. So, Bennie and Millie, is it your heart's desire to serve the Lord? If so, will you answer, we will serve the Lord?
We will serve the Lord.
Friends and family that are here today, if it's your heart's desire, will you say, we will serve the Lord? Amen. It goes on, and I'm going to make this really brief, but it goes on that, let me read this for you, that God's people served the Lord throughout Joshua's lifetime, that generation. The sad thing is the generations after didn't, and there was consequences. I want to encourage you to encourage your family members and your friends to encourage them to the next generation, to serve the Lord. You know, we joke a lot about marriage, and I'll be married 40 years, my wife and I, this summer. And I love my wife, we've been blessed. But we joke a lot, but we need to understand that God is the one who ordained marriage. And three times in Scripture, Jesus said this, at the beginning of creation, God made male and female. For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united with his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one. Therefore, what God has joined together, let no one separate. So Christ tells us that a man and woman are united together, and their commitment, their covenant, is before the Lord. It's the biblical standard of marriage for a man and a woman to share a lifetime commitment to each other, second only to their commitment to the Lord, putting the Lord first. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. At this time, Pastor Dan is going to come and share.
Bennie and Millie asked if I would share some words, some reflections that of their own, and we'll add a few as well. But I love this picture. I didn't realize that it was just taken this past week. Beautiful picture of them, and represents their love for one another, their commitment to one another, and I think the smiles on their faces shows the joy of their hearts, a joy that the Lord gives. But Bennie and Millie met on a Christmas night and were married on December 30th the next year, 1972. Millie was the babysitter for Bennie's nephews. They have lived in Newton all but the first 4 months of their marriage. Bennie worked at pre-stressed concrete for 48 years, retiring in 2020. Millie had several jobs over the years, retiring in 2021 after almost 20 years at Southwest and Associates. Since Bennie and Millie love children, they borrowed nieces and nephews, spoiling them with outings to movies, races, and amusement parks. And in 1989, after Bennie and Millie had been married 16 years, they were blessed with the adoption of their son, Matthew. The next years were filled with the joys and frustrations of parenthood. They are proud of the man he has become.
Amen.
Bennie and Millie enjoy travel, especially cruising. The cruises have taken them to ports in Canada, Alaska, Hawaii, Mexico, the Caribbean, and the Panama Canal. They have also enjoyed camping, fishing, and traveling to visit family and friends and playing cards and games. We have a few other pictures. The pictures that you saw before the service represent a lot of their growing up years and their life together with family and friends. We wanted to give you kind of a snapshot, too, of their participation in church activities over the years as well. So, boy, I don't know how many years it's been that we've been in the same small group together. We call it TLC group, Tender Loving Care. And I think it's been appropriate because there's a lot of love and care that we've shared over the years and with those in that group. So the top picture shows that group and actually shows your mom in that group. And also in the bottom, you'll see that group later on in front of the White House there at John and Mary Bastow's home. The one on the left shows us at a Sunday school class, which is now Pastor Ray's office since we've done remodeling, but a lot and lot of studying the Word together over the years and lots of good times of fellowship together. The next one makes me smile a little bit. The one on the left is Bennie and Pastor Ray looking pretty relaxed at my bachelor party. That was in 1994. And then the one on the right is Millie with Ellen Cowan and Dolores Cook at one of our women's groups events in the 1990s. We had to throw this one in. So when we built on the addition to our what became what was our activity center now, but for many years we needed to use it as the church continued to grow, used it as our worship center for a while. But in preparation, getting everything ready to go for the dedication, everybody had jobs, and Bennie volunteered for the bathroom duty, apparently. Or maybe he got assigned, I don't know. But knowing Bennie's heart, he probably volunteered.
Does he do that at home, I want to know.
Okay, all right. So this is not, obviously, in the 1950s, but we had a 50s party theme for a Valentine's banquet. Believe it was in 2002, and so there they are and on the bike there. It was fun. And then this is a more recent one from just last year at our Valentine's banquet. And then, as I mentioned, this is a more recent, just from this past year at our house, again, from our particular life group, or TLC group, as we call it. But we've just enjoyed many, many special years together and many special experiences together, and it's a joy to celebrate. Well, when they were first married, Bennie and Millie were in love, of course. But it wasn't until a few years later that they found out what true love actually meant when they discovered and experienced the love of God and Jesus Christ, his Son. The verse is found in 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verses 4 through 8, are excellent words to live by and to build a marriage. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrong. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices in the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. To God be the glory. Would you stand and join us as we sing together the great hymn, To God Be the Glory, Great Things He Has Done. You'll be able to see the words on the screen. Please sing along.
Oh,
vows at this time. I charge you both as you stand in the presence of God and these witnesses and renew your wedding vows to remember that your commitment to Christ and to one another avails as the foundation of a godly, blessed home. If the vows you're about to make be kept and you endeavor to do the will of your Heavenly Father, your lives will be full of joy and your home will abide in peace. No other human ties are more tender, no other vows are more sacred than these that you have made and are about to renew. Benny, do you still, this is how you wanted it, the vows to be read, do you still take Millie to be your wife, pledging yourself to her to be faithful, loving, and honorable, to cherish her according to God's holy ordinance? If so, answer, I still do.
I still do.
He still does. Millie, do you take Benny to be your husband, pledging yourself to him to be faithful, loving, and honorable, to cherish him according to God's holy ordinance? If so, answer, I still do.
I still do.
Amen. There's a reason we're saying I still do, okay? We're going to see that at the end here. Having reaffirmed your faith in Christ and your love for each other, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Benny, you've been waiting 50 years for this moment. Okay? You may kiss your bride. Woo! I'm going to have you turn to the...
I know you didn't want to do this, but I must say something.
Wait a second here. I want this on recorded.
50 years ago yesterday, last night, we took our vows, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health. My life has been much better because you have been there by my side. My life has been enriched because you have been by my side. And in health, you've taken good care of me. And in sickness, you've taken even better care of me. But one of the major things of our wedding, our marriage, is that if it had not been for you by my side, I would probably not have the relationship with God that I have today.
Amen. Amen. It's okay to cry. A lot of people out there are crying. I see them. Okay. All right. It is my pleasure to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Benny and Millie Warren. Out there dancing right now. Oh, they would like to greet you in the foyer, and they ask that everyone stay. There's a reception just down the hall, and thank you for coming. The Lord bless you.